The Senate put in extra money for direct care workers, people who help the disabled.
Well, that's pretty sad, too. The governor of the state of New York decided that we wanted to raise the minimum wage, you know, very well intended, I'm sure. But there are, you know, there's fallout from that. There are a number of direct care workers that deal with our handicapped kids and families across this great state. But not only that, but you have nursing, you have assisted living, you have health care workers, you have home care workers. None of that was taken into consideration. We're talking about another $1 billion a year to be able to pay for these increases to that industry. So right now, we made sure that we got $45 billion that was directly needed right now for those direct care workers, the ones that are dealing with those that have developmentally or disabled or have other medical issues, that we can have that money there so that they can get the money that they need to get to the minimum wage. We don't want to see the drain that we have. We have an employee drain because they don't get paid enough. Burger King's paying you $15 an hour. Why are you going to work for $11 an hour taking care of some 70-year-old woman that needs help that's in assisted living or nursing, or a handicapped a child that needs the assistance of getting in and out of bed and getting to and from school? So we did that, and we made sure we put that $45 million into the budget.
Mm-hmm. I can see where the consistency of having that same person really makes a difference for people like that.
They want to see the same person every day. Yeah. You're getting out of that bed, you turn around, that person's going to take you, bathe you, clean you up, get you moving. So you want that consistency.
Mm-hmm, definitely.